fight for my brother, the Hot 9.
They tried to bleach my speech, hoping I'd start speaking white. Said I'm too pro-black for poor blacks who need more rights, not more blocks. Why they more trash than poor whites who get more stripe or more whites who are more rich than the more is who knows what more is. My rapporteur is to report this without money clips or managers till it manages to manifest from mind to flesh in fresh form. So dress form in uniform as I address you in cuneiform with a horn of a Capricorn unicorn. I was born in a winter storm with a heat wave on my spirit and bomb. I entered arm to tight times on before my time, before time was gone. Holding on to 40 songs in two palms like nuke bombs, lukewarm like nude blonde. Not attracted, my muse and mood's gone. So I move on with no poem or no song. Like I know someone, no sun swell, eyes and nose run up. No one but a no man, I know God like a nomad. Travel in my notepad, everything I wrote had insight. So in spite or despite, if you dislike me on this might be a fist fight. So catch a fist right, or it's goodbye, good day, good night, and have a good life. I'm in the good light, I'm good. Right?
Been here in a long time. You know, I haven't been doing poetry, man. I've been doing other things, and I'll just, you know, stretching the poetry out and using inspiration to fuel, like, you know, other things. And I'm gonna get into some of that after I try to get out some of the stuff that, you know, at the calling of Asaji Fool, I had to go back to the drawing board and try to, like, get this energy back up. So I hold hands with touch. Feeling the invisible world around us, there's no such thing as debt, and debt is shallow. Trees have no roots in this jungle, filled with glasses and steel, swinging from light to light like living radiant, ignoring the ignorant because our ignorance has no knowledge of them. Voices wail in the belly of whales in Nazareth, screaming, Jonas not hear it, as comets curvet and connect to get the earth out of orbit, as hearts dip, sun drips, crying light, shining tears, there's no life after the afterlife, so look after life now. Made me a map to the belly of death and my way to my funeral, because I'm dying to die so I can resurrect the truth, the way and the life, resurrect everyone's death that's ever died so I can resurrect myself twice. I know I'm speaking forensic, but it's like Jimi Hendrix is playing the strings of my heart causing a beat down. Come on, who turned the beat down? Turn the beat up so I can speak up to up. What's up, up? Don't get upset. Get your fed up, I know you're fed up, but keep your head up. The sky is not my limit, I jump in the galaxy and swim it. I'm a spirit dressed in metaphors to address the streets. I'm repping for with speech to breathe flesh to reach soul. Don't bleach yourself, blackness is gold. So hold yourself and protect yourself before someone else makes you someone else just so they can become yourself. Wow. Colorblind, watching colored people on color TV. Roy G. B.I.V.D. outlined with white chalk and white thoughts being taught in white schools, thinking white showed the world. Black actors and athletes need a white girl to wife her, not because they like her, but because they like the fact that she's white and they're black, and that means that they've made it across the color line. Colorblind in a land where color binds your existence. Green, for instance, means go. Amber means slow. Red means stop. And black? Well, blacks get shot by white racist cops and rednecks who likes to pop black until you're red, white, or blue, and left black and blue by the same boys in blue who blew Amadou away only to get away silent. Shh. The blue wall of violence is not grayscale, it's failsafe for the pale face, so we fake our namesake and erase our color from our minds to be colorblind, high colorblind, hair colorblind, eye color blue, missing our cultural blueprint, confused and able to move through the green lights without ever green eyes. We can't see MYK our way in the greenhouse without ever green eyes, because in the color scheme, chitlins and colored greens don't matter, only bling bling and money green matters, right? Well, that's until you state that Jesus Christ wasn't white, and whites and blacks afraid to admit it will make Jesus Christ into a spirit. Colorless, I'm still black, powerless, blacklisted, young, black, and gifted, a black male being blackmailed by the White House to push blacks right out through gentrification. Lost without hope, my generation is hooked on dope, shoving white pop up black nose till who knows, we're all like a white Michael Jackson with a tiny two nose. Colorful like the rainbow in a kaleidoscope. Color blind folks try to blind folks with black and white blindfolds around gray clouds on greyhounds. Hellbound with black angels being sent back without labels, used by yellow bellies, rednecks, and darkies.
Fuck them, I'm going to the Pink and Black Panther party. So pass me the color code to Roy G. Biff, because this color garbage is white trash and my black pink is motherfucking colorful. Fire. Black is not a fucking color fool. It's the color pool from which all colors come, and the sun can't paint my color on. I was born in black skin, got melanin practicing Mendelism, resisting the extinction. So what are they thinking? White folks can't wipe me out, and white supremacy can't wipe me out, even though they tried to write me up. My rights saying that if you're white, you are right. If you're brown, stick around. If you're yellow, you're middle. If you're black, get back. But forget that. If you're black, stay black, because everyone's trying to be black. That's why they walk, talk, and act black. But they won't fight back when racism strikes black, so fuck that. If you're not black, give me my black back and go catch a yellow cap with your white lies, for color has no significance. Why do we wear white to weddings and black to funerals?
What?
Why is devil's cake black and angel's cake white? Mm. Why is the family member least like the black sheep? Why is AIDS the black disease? Mm. Why is a white lie a good lie? Why is Jesus painted with white skin and blue eyes? Mm. What happened to being dark and lovely? If white is a standard for beauty, is black synonymous with ugly? Mm. No. Then why do we straighten our hair and bleach our skin? Why do blacks thin their nose and lips? Is it my condition, or am I conditioned with hate for who I am? While the color, while white people tan their skin and thicken their lips as the color black thickens, but with each colored boy colors his neck white, gold, and wrist platinum with pink diamonds mined from African mines, where Africans are dying trying to get your begets. So ask me your colorless questions.
Yes.
I don't mind. Why do I write poems about blacks and whites? Simple. Because I'm colorblind. She goes back on her back. Mm. He goes back on his words.
Yes.
Backs out of his commitment to back her up. She gives him back his ring and takes back her vows. Things are going backwards now. She's in the backyard of his background, pulling back tears till she's back where she started. Mm. At the back door of her back room, with her back sore from the back wounds and the back shots, she fights back till she's right back on her back. Trying to pay back her school loan, back rent, back taxes, while he looks back at his reflection, looking back at him, going back and forth. Back to nothing, back to crime, back to court, back to prison, back to living, back in projects, back to dying, back in cats, it's only come back again, reincarnated, back is pain, back pains from being backstabbed by backbiters, backsliders, and backbreakers who will break his back to make him pay them back at payday, or it's payback, so he's backstage holding back rage, reading the back page of Back to Eden, fighting back his demons, throwing back his life, and back his wife, begging her to take him back on all fours until she asked him, what you want me to take you back? He says to give you back more than I took when I walked out the back door of your heart. I'm here to take back the past. She says, don't make me laugh. You only back because I'm back on my feet and you're back on your ass. He's caught in her backdraft. She says, I'm not that soft. You never get that chance to break my heart again. I won't go back to your games, back to you calling me names, back to your backhands when I back talk. Nigga, back off. You'll be slapped back. If I'm back slapped, I won't be set back so you can get back with me. He gets back to begging, gets back to his knees. She looks back in disbelief and says, why don't you take back the disease and the weeks you left me when you turned your back on me without turning back to see if I got back on my feet? Woo! He gets back to his feet saying, I'm not back here for playing. I'm back here from praying. I understand what you're saying. I turned my back on me, so I turned my back on you. I'm not back so I can just get back on you. You're my backbone, so I came back home to make the facts known, baby. I'm not back because I'm crazy. I'm back because you made me, and maybe this apology can take back the agony I brought to your heart. All I want is a chance. You don't have to take me back, but I need you back in my life as my friend or my wife.
Yes.
I'm not back to bring you hurt or back to make things worse. I'm back to make things work. So even though you hate me and it hurts, baby, for what it's worth, I will always love you back, because you carried me in your womb, and then you carried me on your back. And black woman, for that, I will always have your back. Buh, buh, buh.
Yeah.
What will the future be like now? Now that AIDS plagues the wombs of women punctured by phallic fallacies about love, while mama's on drugs, daddy's locked up, the future's back, but the babies are crying, dying, trying to know why we don't know what the future will be like now. cracked out on crack pipes, cracking jokes at cracks in the mirror, but no one smiling. These are serious times, we're in a graveyard smile, waiting for us to die, so we cry at birth, fearful of living in this world where Bambaataa sleeps with little boys and R. Kelly sleeps with little girls. What will the future be like now? I need to know. Will we reap what we sow? If so, then will these cemeteries grow into a forest of black men? What will happen to the sins of the fathers? Will the Vatican be forgiven them sanctuary and a sanctum return of altar boys they've altered? Should we call them fathers or faggots, priests or pedophiles? Check their profile before it's your child. Father, pedophile, you should pray for my children. Don't see my child as your prey. I'll never walk the church all the same. Never see a Catholic priest and smile again. Claim to be a man at the clock, but just a man after ass, your dirty bumbo clocks. What will the future be like now? Now that terrorism justifies terrorism and we're like detainees in a prison trying to see clearly through a prism given fear everywhere we go. Told that America is our friend and the Arabs are our foes, but trees hanging strange fruits don't grow in Saudi Arabia, Syria, or Iraq. You don't get shot at 41 times because you're black in Iran. See, there Bin Laden lived in Afghanistan, but our Bin Laden is an Anglo-Saxon, white-skinned, white-cheeked, wearing American Klansman, president, senator, congressman, our Candace Land of the Brave, expect its ex-slave to help save it from its grave when its days are up. Uncle Thomas, enough is enough. No more Negro stuff. Condoleezza Rice, here's some national security advice. Soon you'll have no rights. Elder Sampton smoking a slight, Bill Clinton Evan puffing us out and hasn't inhaled since. Just think, we were property, not persons. The white man's burden, kidnapped and stacked and ships reduced to 3/5, hung on ropes, denied the right to vote, enslaved by these folks. Now you want me to wave flags for these folks? Nope. I'm not watching the Arabs, I'm watching you. So what will the future be like now? Now that the president is black and they're still claiming that the best rapper is white and the beltway sniper's like, dear policeman, I am God, demanding 10 million because your children aren't safe anytime, any place, so the future waits inside in us. Unseen, tomorrow seems rough, but have you seen enough to know? Will the economy continue to slow? Will the winds of change blow you off the status quo until we rule this and you lose it because of loose lips? I won't lose sleep. I'm gonna lose sleep with a loose speech and a loop reach. Come on, loop me. I'm the future. You can't shoot me. All my essence, my presence never dies. It only pretends. Look at my eyes. I've seen it all. I'm seeing it all. Wow. What will the future be like now? Will we still eat food? Will winter be hot and summer be cool? Will we move out of space? Will it still be safe to say that you're black? Will rappers still be rapping about selling crack? Will blacks still be fighting for rights in the White House? Will Africa be wiped out by AIDS? How will we raise our children? What will we do when policemen kill them? Will we march the city all or will we torch the city all? I need to know. Will truth or troops set us free? Will we be America's majority at the end of the 21st century? Or will we still be the majority in America's correctional penitentiaries? Mm. What will the future be like? I want to tell you guys a little bit about what I've been doing. You know, I've been writing poetry for a long time, and my earliest inspiration, my biggest inspiration is actually my brother who's right here, Rasa Tiba. And I saw him doing poetry, and I just thought I could do it too. And you know what I mean? I started writing, and it became like an outlet for me to just release a lot of my frustrations and things that I dealt with on a personal level. And I realized, I found that I was really good with words, and I know that I really was really good at putting words together. So I went from writing poetry, and I was actually a member of this team, this very team here, the New American Poets Cafe, I think it was back in 2000. And we went to the Nationals, and I think we ended up in the finals. We didn't win, but it was a great experience. And through poetry, my writing kept on expanding, and I wanted to say more, so I started writing screenplays. And the first screenplay I wrote with a friend of mine, and we didn't know anything about making movies or anything like that. But you know, just being a creative and willing to just take on the challenge, we had a little home video camera, and we got a mic and we just shot our thing. We messed up, we made all kind of mistakes,
But we got it done, and I was able to tell a very good story, and people loved it. And that movie gave me a platform to write another one. And by the time we got the second movie out, it got bootlegs everywhere. And this is my latest film right here. And I've gotten much better at it now. This is it just came out. I just released it. It's something that I wrote and put a lot of thought and effort into. It's called What Goes Around. It's a powerful film on relationships. And I only have a few copies tonight, and I'd love to get your support. So please.